Welcome to Slimehouse TV, the show that brings you the very best in underground movies, cult music, and anything else cool, artistic, retro, and edgy. We're completely switching up the format for this one, so join us as we explore the coolest city on Earth, Tokyo, Japan.
My name's Theo Cane Garvey. I'm an independent filmmaker, an illustrator, retro enthusiast, and journalist, born and raised in the steel city of Sheffield. I'm also known to some as battle rapper, Psychosis Holocaust, but no matter what I'm doing, it's all connected to the fact that I love making art, watching movies, and being creative. On top of all this, along with my team, the Sheffspendables, we've spent the last few years painstakingly putting together the most ambitious project that we've ever attempted, my feature-length post-apocalyptic action-adventure movie, Unit 11. So you could say that we're quite busy, but I couldn't turn down the opportunity to create our own TV show, so me and the team are pulling together all of our resources to let you into our world and speak to other people that are on similar missions to what we are, as well as throwing a ton of other cool stuff just for the fun of it. Because there's so much more out there than what the modern day mainstream media spoon feeds us, not to mention all the amazing old school nostalgia that we forget about, so we're gonna take you on a journey deep underground. This is Slimehouse TV.
That's normal in Japan, that's normal. As you already probably know, Tokyo is like the fashion capital of the world. Everyone here is dressed so sick, like everyone you see, it's got like a bit of swagger about them. You've got some crazy style going on. I'm loving it, I'm in my element, man, and I'm drinking energy drinks with kaiju on them. So yeah, man, element, in my element right now.
I'm gonna treat myself to a mint Oreo crepe. I have no idea what to expect.
Trying.
Imagine that. This is the problem with coming to Tokyo. You're gonna taste something and you're never gonna be able to get anything like it again unless you come back.
Yay, Dragon Ball Z!
Dragon Balls. That's sick. So that Ieuan can have a cigarette, because what we didn't know and what a lot of people probably won't know is that smoking in Japan is just like forbidden. You can hardly do it anywhere. You can't walk in the street with a cigarette. It's like majorly frowned upon. You will get beat by the police here. Big up to the guy in the shop that let us use his little private smoking area. So we've just been all the way through Harajuku, all the mad clothing shops, spent some rate cash, just hammered. We've had about like 5 hours sleep in 3 days, I think. But yeah, it's worth it. Loving it, loving it. So many cool shops, chat to a lot of cool people. People here are very respectful and nice and kind, not like back in the ends. So I think we're gonna smash Akihabara in a bit. So right now in Akihabara, which as you can see is like living in an actual pinball machine. It's probably the closest you'll ever get to being inside the actual Tron. Tokyo, Akihabara just never ceasing to amaze us.
Singing billboards.
Singing billboards.
Screams it when you walk past it.
Fun fact, in Toxic Avenger 2, they turn a guy's nose into one of these.
Purchased myself a weird chocolatey fish pastry thing.
What's he saying?
No, I'm glad I'm not diabetic. Fuck me, that's nice. Really nice. Sweetest thing that I've tried so far, but wow.
So, where are we going then?
Well, we're planning on going to the zoo, to Tokyo Zoo. So we've just jumped on our first tube, train, subway, whatever it's called. And we're going to go to the zoo because I heard they got gorillas and pandas. So let's see how we get on. That's my little catchphrase. Let's see how we get on.
Take note, blood.
Exactly.
It's going to be a good sign, a panda. We'll have a race up these steps because Ieuan's got blisters on his feet because he's not used to walking because he's always in his truck.
Wicked thing about Tokyo that I love, you get one little coin, you put it in here, and it's going to give me a drink of Pepsi. With or with ice, I don't know which one's that, I'll just have to do.
Have a guess.
That one. Oh yeah man. You just get a cup of Pepsi. Sick! Yeah. So we're at Tokyo Zoo now, we've asked if we can take pictures, they said that's cool, so let's see what we can find. Oh, yeah. So we've seen the real life panda, I just want to hug him, but it's probably not a good idea because he'll rip your head off.
He's just eating his bamboo like a G, chilling. Love him, Zoo Yayo.
Definitely.
We've only seen one thing.
One thing and I'm happy. I'm already satisfied. Well and truly satisfied.
What's mad is it's what, 600 yen, which is...
£3?
It's like just £3 or something. £3 to just see a panda's worth it. And they've got Bengal tigers and gorillas and lot here, so I can't believe it, man. He's buzzing. It's a very nice, chilled day.
Oh, man.
He's the biggest yet, the condor. Please come. Oh, he's here, look. Yo!
A lot of people have come to Japan looking for like birds, as in girls, birds. I'm looking for actual birds, vultures, peacocks, mad Japanese wood pigeons. Oh, otters.
Lion.
I can hear something roaring. Let's get to him quick. They can hear that on camera, it's like Cloverfield. Lioness. Shere Khan.
This one here, chilling.
What are you saying, G?
Oh, gremlin.
What are you saying, blood?
One.
Anything with a gorilla on it, I'm there. Gorilla arrow this way, let's go. Oh, look at him, chilling with his cloth on his head.
Me and Slacky are like massive fans of gorillas. I've never seen one in real life. This is like a mad moment for me. Grew up watching King Kong and Son of Kong. And the Willis O'Brien stop motion and stuff. It's like a mad moment to finally see one in real life and he's got a cough and he's a chilling yawning and that is mad.
Pango, where's the pango? And a slow Norris. Oh man, we've come to the right place today. Look at him. Hot tapirs.
They're like a cross between an elephant and a pig, I love them.
Oh, he's the cutest thing I've ever seen.
Pure brass. That'd be worth some coin on scrap.
This is where you find the real animals, the smokers in the cage, in the permitted area. If this were Jurassic World, that's where a mosasaur would be. Yeah, you don't want a picture with his statue. Theo Cane, the next George Miller.
Look at these funny little cute things. He says, Wagwan G. As he walks past his boy. Hello, beautiful. Oh,
big boy's that, so I'm going to go and see him. Size of him. He's bigger than my settee. Yeah.
The size of his head is like.
Look how he turned into a perfect ball. That's an armadillo. That is not a coconut or a basketball.
No, it's
you can't gauge how big this turtle is. It's like over a metre long, maybe like a metre and a half long. I just want to get in and chill with him. Look at him.
This is my dude. I love him. You saying, bruv?
We've just seen It was a wild spider. I don't know what it were, but it was not. At first we think it were in a tank, and then we looked and it weren't in a tank. It were reflected in a tank. It were just next to us. The aliens touched it with a bottle and it's ran.
A bottle, you're recording it?
Go on. Oh, whoa!
Oh, shit. It's
like, I don't know if that's wild or if that's escaped, but that weren't cool.
Not even in a cage.
Not even in a cage.
It's not even in a cage, he's alive. See, that might be normal in Japan, I don't know.
Get me out of here.
British spiders, I pick up with my hand and put outside, no problem. The big house spiders, but that were unbelievable. Watch, we're going to see on here now, there's going to be a cage we want loose. I swear.
Great, nice, he says. I'll let him be the judge of that. So tell the viewers of Slimehouse TV what Square Enix is and why you want to find it so bad.
Well, Square Enix is basically the producers of the Final Fantasy franchise. Final Fantasy VII being the one that really put them on the map. You know, I've loved that game ever since I was a kid. I've become obsessed over it. Final Fantasy VII, IX, but it's more to the VII because that's the classic. I've wanted to go here since I first found out about the place. Also, to pick up a genuine Final Fantasy VII merchandise, even if it's a figure, even if it's a little Moogle, right? I cannot wait to go inside and just see what basically comes out of me.
That's a little plush cloud, maybe even a Moogle. All the soundtracks. The soundtracks from Final Fantasy VII through to where it is now.
Tenner
for that.
Tenner, just a tenner.
Jump back. Hey, it's Batman, man. Futuristic man.
The way you wanted.
What do you want, Ieuan?
I got exactly what I wanted. It was a bit, they didn't have a little figure, but I'm not disappointed at all because this is one of the main things that I come for. Couldn't find another Cloud figure in any shop that we went to. Come to Othnia, Square Enix, sorted, happy as I can be.
So we've been in Artinia, which is like a really cool little cafe for Square Enix. Every single piece of food that they serve is like some kind of Square Enix character, and they've got something called the showcase where they have all like the new items like displayed proper nice. Like, I'm a fan of toys, I love toys, and something I like is when toys are displayed properly, so big fan of that place. Hold that memory for a long time, I think. Definitely. Very, very sick, and the boys back home are gonna be very jealous, which is always nice. Take a picture. Is that cool?
Oh,
okay. Arigato. Thank you. Watch that you don't fall on the line, because then everyone would have been like, ah! Just on about sad people that go on holidays and they go to hotels that are all inclusive and they don't even leave the pool. They don't even leave the hotel. They just chill by the pool all day, drinking the all inclusive beer and eating the all inclusive crap food. I'm saying like I need a week's rest after this holiday for how much walking and stuff we've been doing, but it's wicked. I'm loving it. I'm loving every minute. So we're gonna try and find Tokyo Tower now. And yeah, see what that's saying. Slimehouse TV in Japan. So it looks like we found Tokyo Tower. Let's go and see if we can get in it or on it or up it. Just another thing that you'll never be able to gauge the size of unless you're here. Like, it's massive, man, and it looks like there's a disco going on inside, so we need to go and check that out.
Oh, feel the love, Ieuan.
I feel the love.
The queue to get in Tokyo Tower is like a mile long, but we're here, so we're gonna go for it.
We are going up to the 250 meter high special observatory.
Just a thing of beauty, just taking it all in, man. Like, this is a dream come true for me and Ieuan. Like, since college I've been watching Kamen Rider and Ultraman and Godzilla, and Takashi Miike movies, and to actually come here is a dream come true. Just taking it all in is very bizarre. It's still, I'm quite sunk in the way in Tokyo, in Japan, somewhere that I've dreamt about coming for years and years and years. Just taking it all in, man. It's mesmerizing, it truly is.
Who painted all this so red? And who has to keep painting it this red to keep it looking so red?
Filming thing of it,
sitting on. Chilling. I want to take one of these home, get it on plane. No one's looking, go!
We just ran down like 800 steps from the top of Tokyo Tower because we could be off in a lift.
It like squeezes some potato through like a press and it makes the chips come out.
Off she gets the dough. I just want to show the process how you do it. It's clever. Everyone does it. Everyone in Japan does this when they take a picture or anything. Because it's peace around here. Everyone's loving everything. Respect, brother. Thank you.
Arigatou.
Wow, look at this. Damn, yo. Bad. Love it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Very
cheers.
Cute.
Yeah, bro. It's got some crazy rice-filled bacon wrap sausage type thing.
What's it saying, G?
Yeah, try it.
Go on then.
Exactly the same as what Theo said. I'm going to be gutted because I can't get this back in chef. Bad.
We've got quite a messed up sleeping pattern because, I mean, it took like 24 hours of pure travelling to get here. Like a 4-hour plane to Turkey, and then a 2-hour wait, and then like a 12-13 hour flight from Turkey to Japan, and then a load more messing about, and another hour and a half drive just to get to where we are. So our sleeping pattern's pretty messed up. Ieuan's just upstairs asleep, and it's just mad, man. I'm just having a little walk around on my own, just kind of taking it all in. Since before I can remember, I've wanted to come to Tokyo, Japan. Like, something I've always wanted to do, always. It's always been too expensive for me, but we've done it, man. It's mad. Like, me and Ieuan come from nothing. We're not from these rich families that's got loads of money. Like, we come from nothing. 2 years ago Ieuan was homeless. Like, 3 years ago I didn't even have a job and stuff. Like, I lost my job and everything, and it's not been easy, but it just shows that if you really want to do something, no matter what it is, you can do it. It's been mad. I've had so much pressure from like getting this TV show finished and getting the movie finished and stuff. It's been like a lot of pressure from all angles, and then a lot of personal stuff that's gone on in my life, and it's, do you know what I mean? It's been wicked just to show anyone that's doubted me, or anyone that's doubted us, or ever, all the people that just say you can't do stuff, just don't listen to them, man. You can. Look at us now, we're in Japan. We're just like 10 minutes from Akihabara. We're in Tokyo, and it's wicked, and I'm loving it. When people tell you you can't do stuff, you can do it, you can do whatever you want. You can always do whatever you want. I'm from Ackenford, man, in Sheffield, a rubbish little rundown estate with crackheads, where there's burglaries, where there's robberies. And then we're here now in Tokyo, Japan, like one of the coolest, most vibrant electric cities in the world, where everyone's proper nice. Everyone gives you a nod in the street, gives you a bow. There's no litter on the street. Like, even leaves fall off the trees within seconds, they're swept up. It's mad. Like, they take such pride in the country. It's my kind of place, and I'm really enjoying it. We've got like another 3 days here, so just want to keep smashing it and see what happens next. So it's raining torrentially in Tokyo, Japan today. We haven't really got too much of a plan, we're just going to go out and see what cool stuff we can find, probably go back to Akihabara.
We complain about a bit of rain in England as well.
Things that make this country absolutely spectacular. Little things like this that you wouldn't even think of.
Whee!
Oh, it's dry!
Right now. In Electric City, Akihabara. Kylo. Sheffspendables up in Japan.
Yeah.
Crab food disc.
Crab food disc USB.
You can have your favourite Japanese food that looks realistic. And it's a USB stick.
Yeah, Ian's got his phone when it rains, so we're trying to get an Allen key to fit it. And I don't know, is it Allen key in Japanese, so we're just having to wing it.
No idea.
No joy. So I think we're advertising Chromecast. And then, of course, there's like five scantily clad young Japanese Power Ranger girls advertising it. Because that's just how it is in Japan. Ian's getting right pissed off. Sorted, Ian.
Sorted,
arigato. Yeah, thank you. Now a wet phone can now be a dry phone and we can get the map working again to know where the hell we are.
Just gone from torrential downpour to now.
It's sunny and it's warm. I'm glad I didn't put my other layer on underneath.
Only in Japan.
Let's listen to hip hop there. It's funny, no matter where you go in the world, you see another hip hop fan and you're like, yes, bro, respect, and they just get it.
I was wondering if animals could talk, but the Japanese ones, the ones from Japan have Japanese accents, but they talk Japanese. I think stupid things like that.
This is where you go to get your game.
Oh, this is where they sell toys. I've seen it on internet. Akihabara, Radio Kakian. This is where I might find some toys. I'm looking for Godzilla, Kamen Rider, Kaiju.
TVs everywhere.
Coolest shop. Look. Stars, RPD. Ready for that Raccoon City outbreak.
Ah. What's all here?
That's sick. 28,000 yen.
I was looking for the neck care product. What bra size you want?
Crazy dolls.
Guns.
Won't be bringing none of these back, unfortunately.
Find a toy you want and then write it down, I think that's what you do. So that's what I'm trying to do. I want these Ultraman baddies.
Ejecto suit.
As much as I'd like to sit on it, I don't want to be catapulted to the tent.
It'd be sick converted into a gaming chair.
Yeah.
This shop, I don't know what it's called, it's got a yellow sign, there's like 9 floors of toys. As you can see, man, it's just madness. It's an assault on the senses here. It's like living in a Sega game, but it's very cool. We're loving it.
Biggest kind of fan that you'll ever find. Great.
On the way to the aquarium because I want to see an octopus.
and a manta ray and whatever else they've got, a giant
shark and live dolphins.
Sharks, dolphins, so we're gonna check that out. Let's go. So we're here at Tokyo Aquarium and I'm going to try and find an octopus because I really want to see one in real life. I never have, and I'm a big fan of octopuses. Whatever the plural for them is, I don't like that.
Bastard.
Leopard eel.
Get teeth. Fish.
Put teeth on him.
I think I found a dolphin, man. I've never seen a dolphin in real life. It's a mad time. It's sick, look at the size of it.
It's a hula hooping dolphin.
Well, it only cost like a fiver to get in, and it was worth it just for that, just to see them dolphins. They were right clever. I got wet, but it don't matter, I'm chilling. We found our first octopus.
He's only tiny, but he's sick.
This is my guy, chilling.
There's this one here.
An octopus can get through pretty much anything, as long as it's as big as his beak. They have like a beak in there.
That's what that tube's for, they'll pass through that tube.
He'll pass through that tube.
Oh, there's one in the back here,
isn't there? There's one. There we go.
The hall of mirrors. Where does this take us?
Nobody knows.
God knows. Hopefully to something sick. I told him coming near was the best idea ever.
It's like a saber squirrel fish.
Just literally like another wicked thing about Japan and Tokyo. Pretty much coolest place I've ever hung out. With some mad sea life.
Put your hand in. Oh, they eat it in.
And it's actually one of them things where the fish eat your dead skin. I'm not doing it, I've got my glove on.
Really?
Right, this is what I come for, the giant Pacific octopus who just found him. I'm not sure how big he is, I bet he looked. Oh, he's inch. He's a cool, he's a good size, he's a good size. Look at him, man.
We see his beak.
Not quite hidden than that.
It's in there, look.
In there.
Eat that view, man.
Easily.
Any day. Well, I'm buzzing now. Everything else is a bonus, man. That's where I come to see the fish work.
That's a fish.
That's a fish?
That's a fish.
Where's his eyes?
It's a stonefish.
A nautilus.
Nautilus.
The same name as the Captain Nemo's ship, my hero.
Electric eel, that's his shock. Look at him. Electric catfish. I know someone would like to catch one of them. We're in some like Godzilla proof concrete bunker thing. I've just been obsessed with sea life since I watched The Water Babies as a kid, and this place is wicked. I've been to the deep and stuff in the UK, but this is like the best aquarium ever.
There's dolphins and seals and people all just chilling in harmony like it's no. It's funny. We're walking on a seal.
I was hoping there'd be more crabs. I love crabs. I've got a bit of an affinity with them. I think they get quite a bad rep. But they're wicked, and that's why I'll never eat one. We're saying bye to all the fish now. The aquarium were wicked. I proper enjoyed it. We both did. We're going to try and find something else that I want to find out. One of the last stops of Japan of the trip. So this should be good. Just approaching like one of the biggest things that draws me to Japan, and I'm looking at it now kind of, and it's more impressive than I ever imagined. This is what I'm talking about, man. 1.1 scale Gundam Wing RX782. This is why you gotta love Japan, man. And while we're building like crappy fountains and stuff in UK, they're building 1.1 scale Gundams, man. Japan, I'm putting it right, I tell you.
It was like a Diver City Plaza arcade, man, smashing it. Probably the first proper arcade we've been to since we come to Tokyo. A lot of them are just full of the pachinko and the slot machines, but this is an actual arcade. I want a pirate ship, I'm gonna fight a Kraken. It's a Kraken attacking the ferret.
Transparent one, I love transparent toys.
There he is.
Off, armour. Oh, he's sick.
RX782.
Oh, look how sick the detail. I don't know if the camera can pick up the detail on that, but damn, yo.
Oh my god. It's rolling.
Come and see, Tom.
That's a staff, innit?
Mm. Like lava time. Very sick.
Tokyo Diver City Plaza, such a sick place, man. We were chillier all day. We want to wait for the Gundam to light up, so we were like, what we're going to do to kill time? Well, we had no problem killing time in here. Sick shots, sick arcade, sick entertainment. Slime House TV in Japan.
Theo, tell the audience what you're thinking of Diver City Tokyo Plaza.
I'm saying that it pisses on Meadow Wall. They've got the sickest arcade, they've got the Gundam shop that we didn't even know was in there. And then yeah, we stuck around to see the show with the Gundam 1.1 scale. Wicked, man, wicked. Just another reason why Tokyo's one of the most magical places in the world.
Yo, Ieuan, where are we at, fam?
We are at Tokyo Skytree.
And I'm currently queuing for the Tokyo Skytree, which I believe is bigger than the Tokyo Tower, so that'll be good, because that was like the biggest thing I've ever been up or ever seen ever.
The very highest point.
The highest point possible.
450 metres above sea level.
My ear's popping again. Arigato. Hey. Hello, hello.
This is how high it is.
So we're just gonna go higher now in the Tokyo Skytree. There's something that's
even more cooler is that it's Star Wars themed. So we're gonna go higher and see how high we can get.
Got all these characters, classic stormtrooper, R2-D2 and R5-D4, C-3PO. They're my favourite Endor Rangers. Everyone's favourite bounty hunter, Boba Fett. Detail on them's just unbelievable. Oh, check out Kylo Ren looking bad boy.
It's crazy in Hawaii looking at a city I've seen Godzilla and Megalon and Mothra and Gigan and everyone else has trashed so many times, and now I'm here seeing it from the highest point possible unless you're in a plane. So we discovered that the can, what we put like cold coffee in a can, is actually hot chocolate in a can, and it's right nice. Warm vending machines, that is the future. Why? Because it's Japan, that's why. Sheffspendables in Japan, boom. Just another shot where I lose my shit. The Ultraman store in Tokyo, look. Ultraman Milius, Ultraman Diner. I've loved Ultraman since I was a little kid, and I got the video from the video rental shop and just didn't know what it were, but loved it. She even gave me a free gift, because she says I was kakoi, which means cool. So I got a free gift, which is wicked. Yeah, man.
Kaiju!
We found you, Ieuan.
We have found make your own burger and fries.
I've seen these on internet, and you basically make a miniature burger and fries. I like these carrots, whatever they are. I don't know what they are, but they look cool. Right next to the Kalashnikov, found a giant bag of crisps.
Found an Uzi that fires sweets into kids' mouths.
Gun safety at its finest.
These masks remind me of Three Ninjas. Colt, Rocket and Tum Tum. Four strands of rope, separately you will snap, but together you will be strong. Three Ninjas. Outside the Tokyo Sky Tree on our last night of being in Tokyo, and I think we've both had the time of our lives. It's been wicked, man. Big up, Ieuan. Smashed it. Been a sick holiday. We've just got one final stop before we wrap this thing up. Boom! So here we are, the final stop of our tour of Tokyo, Japan. Shibuya Crossing, the busiest crossing in the world. It's mad, the otaku in me is going crazy right now. Just because I've seen it in so many films, and I wanted to visit this place for so long, and this is always a place that brings me back to everything that I wanted to do when I come to Japan, and we're finally here on the last day. We're taking it all in, it's like a hoverboard away from Back to the Future, man. It's wicked, it's unbelievable, it's the craziest place I've ever been to. This whole city is just fire. So we're right in the middle of Shibuya Crossing. Boom! The busiest crossing in the entire world right now. Tattoo. Dinosaur. It's fresh.
Hi.
Yeah. You got tattoo?
No.
No?
No. Oh. Respect.
Arigato.
Arigato. It's funny because they've never seen tattoos here. So they look at your tattoo and they go a bit crazy.
Randomly having a guy stroke my hand as he walks past me.
So we're in the middle. Thanks for watching. We hope that we covered it well for you. Two lads from Sheffield, Sheffspendables smashing Japan. And we'll catch you next time, whenever that may be, on Slime Mouse TV. When you've got a messed up sleeping pattern like us, like 24 hour snack shops are an essential.
The only thing I'm worried about now is that it's not ever going to get any better than this. Like, there's nowhere else you could visit that would be on the same level as Tokyo for technology and robots and lights and cool stuff.
Respect, brother. Appreciate it. Thank you. Respect. Okay.
Thank you for coming.
Yeah, we're going to come back again with all our crew.
Okay, you're welcome.
Thank you. Cheers, bro.
The size of a can of Young Smiths. Just dressed crazy and no one judges anyone. It's cool. It's quite ironic because I judge a lot of people normally, but maybe not after I've been to Japan.
We've kind of got bored of doing the not allowed to jaywalk thing, and you've got to wait for green man. I won't lie, we're just walking across roads now. We're going back home soon, we've got to get back in chef mode.
Borosaurus from King Kong Escapes and from Destroy All Men. It might never get any better than this.
The bar's been set.
The bar's been raised very high. I don't. Sheffspendables in Japan.